Thank you. celebration together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us all acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. And therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
have mercy.
So that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to my words. You who are Israelites, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God, with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man, delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad and my tongue has exulted. My flesh too will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus. Of this we are witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father and poured him forth as you see and hear. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
There is no
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you invoke as Father him who judges impartially according to each one's works, conduct yourselves with reverence during the time of your sojourning, realizing that you were ransomed from your futile conduct handed on by your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless, unblemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. That very day, the first day of the week, two of Jesus' disciples were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem called Emmaus, and they were conversing about all the things that had occurred. And it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them. But their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know of the things that have taken place there in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sort of things?" They said to him, "The things that happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word, before God and all the people. How our chief priests and rulers both handed him over to a sentence of death and crucified him. But we were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since this took place. Some women from our group, however, have astounded us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, "Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophet spoke. What is not necessary that the Christ should suffer? Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?" Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, they had the impression that he was going on further. But they urged him, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening and the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. And it happened that, while he was with them at table, he took bread, said a blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With it, their eyes were open and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scripture to us?" So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, "The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Oh, that's a powerful gospel. One of my favorite gospel from St. Luke. And because it is one of a very meaningful gospel account of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, once its beauty, there are artists who would interpret this in their paintings. So two famous artists paint this, okay? One is from Robert Zund, Z-U-N-D, a Swiss painter who painted Jesus on the road to Emmaus with his two disciples. The painting, Jesus is in the center of these two disciples walking towards Emmaus. And what's interesting in this painting, so colorful. You can see the sky, clouds, oak trees. Of course, it's rich, so the surrounding looks like the countryside of Lucerne in Switzerland. That's one painting. Jesus interpreting the scripture to them on the way to Emmaus, on the road. Another painting is from Caravaggio, and this is what we call the meal at Emmaus. Jesus put in the center of the table, breaking bread, with three of the disciples. Two of them, obviously, who was walking with him on the road to the village called Emmaus, 7 miles away from Jerusalem. What's interesting in these two paintings is this. There's a lot of interpretation. One, Jesus teaching the scripture, sulla scriptura. So our Protestant brothers and sisters would gravitate on that. The second painting, Caravaggio, meal. Again, Jesus continued to share the scripture with his disciples. Scripture and tradition. The breaking of bread. Starting from the miracle of the wedding in Cana to the Last Supper, and it continues these days. Scripture and tradition. Okay. It is not about Jesus teaching himself in these two paintings depicted, but it is the presence of Jesus in his disciples. The presence of Jesus with his disciples. Emmanuel, God is with us. So when we look at this gospel passage, we discover that Jesus draw near to his disciples. He's reaching out. is reaching out. And the account of this road to Emmaus, these two disciples, of course they're fearful, of course they're doubting, of course there's uncertainty, no question about this human experience and condition. The Christ that they taught will bring salvation and redemption to the Israelites in a worldly context, dead. Okay? So their fear. So they have to get out of Jerusalem to save their life. Okay. Why is it so important to us to reflect upon this gospel, this time? Isn't it that we're in this pandemic, uncertainty, doubt, fear, you know, all this human condition. Of course, we will experience all this. But again, Jesus, draw near. Okay? That's the beauty of this gospel. Jesus, draw near to his disciples. We heard the gospel story. We know the knowledge of Jesus Christ in our life. Somehow, when we experience this kind of emotions in our life, we lose sight of Jesus. God is with us, Emmanuel. Yet, Jesus continues to walk with us. Jesus continued to walk with us. And pay attention to this question he asked his disciples. What sort of things? What sort of things? Whew. That question draws deep in my heart, because then we can ask ourselves, what sort of knowledge I gain about Jesus? What knowledge we have about Christ. See the question? What sort of things? It brought us into the perspective that yes, we should know Christ. Yes, we have these signs and symbols and testimonies about Jesus Christ. But what do we do with that knowledge in our life? How would that knowledge transform us? I think that question, what sort of things, now draw us to a living out of that knowledge. Living out of that knowledge. It allows us to pause a little and meditate upon the knowledge we learn of Christ. And how can we use that knowledge to guide our life and to live our life during this time of uncertainties and doubts and fear? Knowing your friend and living with your friend is what we call relationship. Relationship. Knowing a friend and spending time enjoying the company of one another is what we call relationship. So as Jesus draw near and walk with them, he built that assurance of a relationship with them. And remember, they were gravitated with Christ along the way. And then when they found that Christ is going to walk further, what was they said to him? They begged him to stay with us. Stay with us. That's what relationship is. We stay with one another. We spend time with each other. Together we will build. Together we will confront and face this fear, doubt, and uncertainties of our lives. Together we share love. We care for one another. And that's what Jesus did. And this is a very difficult for all of us. The next and the following segment of this gospel passage. Jesus stayed with them, took bread, blessed, broke, and gave it to them. Why is it so difficult at this time? I know you're there. You can partake in this wonderful sacrament that Jesus left us. You cannot take physical the body and blood of Jesus Christ. So it's really, it breaks our heart because we're distancing from one another, where in fact we are used to the tradition of being together and commune together and to share this life with Christ and to partake it. That ordinary thing, a tradition that we have, now have a pause. And you're there in your comfort of your own, us bringing this word of Jesus Christ to you. And of course, we're spiritually in communion with us. But we're human beings, you know, our senses. We need that reception. We need to touch it. We need to taste it in order for us to make it more ordinary to us. But my brothers and sisters, that's the reason why I said it's so difficult to share the second part of the gospel, because that Saint Gaudentius of Brescia says the sacrifice, the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist, the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, is our sustenance on our life's journey. See, that's so painful for us. Today, we miss our ordinary ritual, our public liturgy, where we are together. And I'm sure you will miss your neighbors here in the pew. You recognize them, you have that in your memories. You know who's sitting beside you, what they usually do, you know, all that. But soon it will come back. Senses are doors of knowledge. Senses are doors of knowledge. And that's why we don't stop ringing the bells. Because that bells signify our hope of gathering back together. Spiritual communion brings consolation that we will all be together once again. This is just a pause for all our safety measures. But it's not the end. We will be back together. Pictures, images that we see. You know how many people comment on the pictures we post on our Facebook account? I miss our church. I miss our community. We miss one another. That brings somehow a consolation and hope that somehow soon, hopefully, we will be together as parish community. We miss you. We miss you. And that's why today we have a little bit of an effort to bring to you Christ as we bless you. I hope you could participate safely as we go through this drive-by blessing around 11 a.m. today here at our parish. Okay, stay in your vehicle and we will just bless you as you pass by. Okay? And we will be glad to see you, even just a glimpse of you, knowing that you're well, knowing that you're gearing towards and hoping of being in communion physically once more with your parish community. We are on the road to Emmaus. And remember who drew near and walked with us. Remember who is the person drawing himself and walking with us. Those paintings remind us of the Christ Emmanuel with us, guiding us, walking with us, opening our minds and heart to the positive things that we can rest our soul and our well-being at this time of uncertainties and fear. And lastly, for all of you who think of us, your church, and send your contributions so that we can sustain our parish and our school, knowing that our teacher is still teaching, knowing that all of us here are getting ourselves to continue operates our parish and our school. Thank you so much for your consistent generosity and thought and prayers. And soon we will be together. But remember, who is with us all the time? Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With joy at Christ rising from the dead, let us turn to God, our Father, in prayer, trusting that he will hear and answer us.
For Pope Francis and Bishop Brennan, that they lead in faith and serve in love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For lawmakers and all elected officials, that they enact just laws that protect life from conception to natural death, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing for abuse survivors, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims of coronavirus and the healthcare workers who care for them, that they be strengthened by the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of the parish for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers in our Book of Intentions and for the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially for Clark Morton, that they enjoy eternal peace in the kingdom of heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of the living, we find our hope in your Son's resurrection. Graciously grant our petition in accord with your will. We ask all this through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. brothers and sisters, with my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her costs for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain, who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together again in the name of your glory as they attain. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered in your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, with the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. You will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael the Archangel, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Mark our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and all who are pleasing to you of their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, who will bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the love of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other this time of peace. Blessed. others called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be.
Lord Jesus Christ, I believe you to be truly present in the most blessed sacrament of the altar. At this time I am pained because I am unable to receive you in Holy Communion, but I beg that you come into my soul and provide me with all of the graces that I need and all of those which I would have received had I been able to receive you in the most holy Eucharist this morning. Lord Jesus, we beg these things according to your most infinite mercy, making all of these appeals to your Eucharistic heart. And we ask all of this in your most holy name. Amen.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in the flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before the blessing, we'd like to thank Chad again for being with us. I think it's wonderful to have music during our liturgy, so thank you, Chad. We're getting professional as well in terms of our videoing and streaming. We have Frank Wisbis this morning taking care of our video. Thank you, Frank, and also Carrie Below from all of us here. And also, we'd like to remind all of you again, we will have a drive-by blessing at 11 o'clock, rain or shine, stay in your vehicle, and then we will go from Linwood, take Linwood Avenue, turn right towards our parking lot from the back of the rectory, and then go out towards National Road, going through, passing by the whole passageway between the church and the school. Okay? okay? And we will be there, and I'm sure some of our staff and school community as well will be there to say hello to you, of course, with social distancing, okay? So see you at 11 o'clock. And now for the blessing, please respond amen to every blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work, you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Go in peace, the mercy sent in the living.